Hello, today we'll be discussing the internal lithium battery on the Campbell Scientific CRVW3 and why you may need to replace it. The lithium battery does provide a real-time clock for the unit. And the lithium battery is only used if you do not have power to the data logger. So sitting on a shelf will drain the lithium battery, whereas powered up will not drain the lithium battery. So we'll just go in here really quick and show you how you'll check your lithium battery. We're using our device configuration software, and we select their COM port, and we will connect to this. It has found the CRVW3. It's pulling up the information now. So in the data monitor, we will look at the status table. And this is called the RTC battery right here. This is a new battery, but we will show you how to replace your battery and what you must do when you replace the battery. It is always a good idea, while this battery only keeps the real-time clock alive, it's not a bad idea to collect data at any time. So we're going to collect all the data from the CRVW3. We're going to collect the vibrating wire data right here. We've only been running this program for a short time. It only has 13 records, so it's a small data file. Your data files might be substantially bigger. Now that we've collected data, we can go to the physical replacement of the lithium battery. We'll disconnect this. We will remove the lead acid battery. Get it out of the way. And in doing so, we have a few tools we'll need. We have a Phillips screwdriver for these screws right here at the very back. There are two of them. We have a 5/16 inch nut driver that will be used to remove the antenna connector nut. And we can start that now. I'll loosen this nut, spin it off the rest of the way. And when these get tightened, it is a D-shaped connector, so you might have to turn it a little quarter of a turn just because it kind of tightens up against the enclosure. Once you turn it counterclockwise, counter quarter of a turn, you should be able to push that through just like that. This prevents ripping the antenna cable from the body of the data logger when you remove it. Also, this copper ground lug can be removed just by counterclockwise turning it. Now we will remove the two Phillips screws at the back of the enclosure. You can either pull these out or just allow those to fall in the enclosure, as we'll be taking this out anyway. So if the screw falls off the end of the screwdriver or off your fingertip, nothing to worry about, just like that. So in removing this from the enclosure, as I had said, we'd push the antenna cable connector through the hole of the enclosure so it's not going to bind. And we'll just pick this up and pull it out. And there's our screw. Now to get to the lithium battery, it is a spring-loaded connector. And there is a groove on the bottom here for that battery to slide in and out. I find it easier to use a little screwdriver or to pry this up and kind of push it out with the screwdriver so that the battery free falls. It is a CR2025 battery that we use in this. And in replacing the battery, sometimes if you pull on this tab too much, you can remove some of the tension. So we can tighten that a little bit with our thumb, just so the battery is tight when we replace it. It shouldn't rattle around. You should be able to slide it in and hear it click into place like that with an audible click. Okay, now that we have that completed, we're ready to reassemble this into the enclosure. The first thing we'll do, since the antenna cable is slotted with a D shape, we have to align it into the hole. We'll just rotate it enough till we find the slot in the hole. We will also just angle this in to where the LEDs just barely touch the tip of the enclosure, like that. And another piece, there is a washer on the back of here to make sure that the antenna connector is grounded. And I heard it rattling around. That's one thing I did not check. So I'm going to put this washer back onto the antenna connector. And this just provides better surface area for the ground connection. And I'll do this once again. I'll orient the D-shaped slot this time so it's easier to find. I'll slide that in. Again, I'm going to angle this to where the tip of the LEDs just barely protrude the holes in the enclosure, and then I lower the rest of this into place. Now, while trying to hold this with two hands, if you insert the ground lug back into this and just rotate it clockwise a couple of times, you can spin that on to where this will hold the data logger portion in place in the enclosure, so you have access hands-free for your other assembly items. We'll put the nut back on the antenna connector, spin it on, and then tighten it. It doesn't have to be heroically tight, but you do want it tight and firm. Then we can place the screws, the Phillips screws, into the back of the enclosure. And part of putting the ground lug in helps to align this back into the enclosure, so you have your hands free to hold the screw head in your fingertips. I'm just going to spin these on and then give them a final tighten. And it should align into the chamfered holes. We will now put the battery back in. Plug it in, and we'll fasten the battery hinge. Now that we have changed the lithium battery, we will want to set the data logger clock, because that battery keeps the real-time clock alive. And once we connect to this, we'll see that the battery has defaulted back to a beginning date of the CRVW3. So we'll connect back to this. And note, once it comes up here, we go into the logger control. We'll see that the data logger clock has been diverted back to the original date. So we want to set the clock to our laptop time. And just to verify everything, we'll go into the settings editor, and we'll see that our naming nomenclature for our piezometers, in this case piezometers 10, 20, and 30 meters deep, remain the same. All of our configurations stayed the same. we should be able to redeploy the CRVW3 at this time with no further actions necessary.